ravine at about 4,000 feet. Above us is the ravine itself, around the summit of Mount Hampshire. Right now, on the summit, the temperature is zero.
Climbing team at the Pingree School. The team climbs all seasons, but winter is the core of the program. As a team sport, Pursuit has played more away games than any other team at Pingree. The Himalaya, the Swiss Alps, the Grand Tetons, the Alps of New Zealand, and of course the mountain range, which has the worst recorded weather in the world, the White Mountains. These are our playing fields. The first step for any mountaineer is training. Hours and hours spent agonizing and developing the physical skills necessary for climbing. This occurs not in the mountains, but at our own front door. The training is continual and takes hours of dedication. And of course the Pursuit motto is pain is pleasure. Pursuit is a small family where everybody learns to trust and look out for everybody else.
When winter pursuit first began, the definition would be a snowball throwing program. 2 days a week we used to go over to the hill next to Pingree and throw snowballs at each other. That was winter pursuit. Since 1976 we have tried to develop competency in terms of winter mountaineering. We try to teach students how to use ice axes, crampons, and snowshoes, how to pack a pack, etc. This coming year, we have plans to begin to talk about and develop expedition mountaineering skills and also alpine expedition skills. Expedition would mean overnight camping. Alpine would mean taking a day pack out and trying to climb Mount Washington, Mount Lafayette, mountains of that type. Thank you.
is a growing experience for both the individual and the group. Pursuitists participate in group activities that stress the importance of participation, for in many ways, mountaineering is the ultimate team sport. The wall is a group problem, in which the team is confronted by an 11-foot smooth vertical wall with no handholds. Roping the team members together adds to the problem and helps accustom team members with working with ropes which will become their lifeline on the mountain. It's this kind of activity that makes pursuit unique.
Began in 1972, we modeled ourselves very much after the Outward Bound program. I would say over the last 5 years, we've become much more in the vein of the Knowles program, which is an outdoor leadership program. Right now, in addition to outdoor leadership, we're also trying to become a service-oriented program, which means that we're trying to get involved in trail maintenance with the AMC and also involved in rescue work and rescue assistance.
Unlike other sports, there are no chalk lines or rules to protect a mountain climber. This is where Solo comes in. Solo, Stonehearth Open Learning Opportunities, is a rescue school in Conway, New Hampshire. All winter pursuitists must attend Solo, where they learn and relearn the basics of first aid and mountain rescue. Solo was founded and is run by Frank Hubble, who is a physician assistant and who works for the National Mountain Rescue Service.
Control. You should have done that way back up here with C. We may have missed it. Or a big spot of blood growing inside of a parka. If you notice it's a big red spot on your blue parka, something wrong.
Frank Hubble is a friend of pursuitists everywhere. The first graduating class of Solo was a pursuit team.
I've just been asked what the hardest rescue was we've been on. Without a doubt, the most difficult rescue we've had would have been where we had to rescue our own mountain rescue member after being avalanched during a rescue at Mount Washington last winter. It was very difficult because of the extreme conditions of approximately 30 degrees below zero, 100 miles an hour, plus wind, and then all the emotions associated with trying to rescue one of your own personnel and your own rescue members. That would be our hardest one.
One of the interesting aspects of pursuit is that the program seems to draw creative talents. Take, for example, the music of Brooks, Melinda, and Brian.
Since then, we've had pursuit at Solo every year. pursuit has changed drastically in the sense that the program has matured from the aspect of being, instead of being dedicated towards just pursuing. Hey, Hoser, let me tell you about this. From pursuing just an academic aspect of the outdoors, reading silly books on the outdoors, things like that, to actually participating outdoors, but more on a level of skills, dedication, learning skills and knowing skills, and personal respect for the outdoors and the emotional involvement with the outdoors. And that's about as much BS as I can throw right now. Okay, sum all this up. This has been brought to you by Ocean Spray Apple Juice.
Part of the syllabus at Solo includes unwinding, and that means the annual tennis ball fight. This is where all the training and preparation comes into play. It is here that the rehearsal ends and the actual performance begins. The climbers strip down, make last equipment checks, and then begin their adventure. Thank you.
Pursuit is not just climbing. It's being a part of something bigger than yourself.